Hi friends, today we are going to see about the diet in pain management. Most of us think that there is no connection between pain management and diet. Or what we do is, once the patient comes with pain, then we ask them to be in certain type of diet, we give some restriction to them. But in actual, if you see, there are a lot of connections between diet and the occurrence of pain. The patient might have had some food. Because of that food, the patient may have some pain. So that is what signs tell us. There are some food substances which are anciently called as rajasic or tamasic food. Okay, the rajasic food are the one which all increases our taste buds sensation, and which is very rich and very nutritious. Nourishment is also a lot in that, and the glycemic indexes are usually high for rajasic food. Imagine what a king would like to eat. So all these things are rajasic food, like high spicy diet, very sweet diet. All these things are rajasic food, very oily diet. And tamasic food are the one, by the name itself you can say it is preserved food, which is not taken hot, which is used for a long duration before consuming, in between the cooking and the consumption. So all these things are called tamasic food. And this rajasic food will, what happens, it increases your temper tantrums in your body. And this tamasic food can render you very lazy and very inactive. And there is one more type of food called as sattvic food, which is the ideal food. So here what the ancient people advised was maintaining the temperature of the food was very important. The temperature of the food was in alignment with the digestive agni. That means you have some sort of a temperature to maintain the homeostasis of the digestion in your small intestine. And that is maintained by means of the temperature of the food what we are eating, and the freshness with which we are consuming it. So these are all ancient concepts. So what normally food that was advised for overcoming pain is eating some sattvic food. That is a food which is not cooked very long time back. Have to be consumed using at least a mild heat in the food should be retained when you are consuming the food. And it should be fresh leafy vegetables, and which is not high in either sweetness or spiciness or oily nature. So that is called as a sattvic food. So that will also inculcate some sattvic attitude in patient people. So in those days they said, tell me what you eat, I'll tell you who you are. Now once the after the science has come out, science also is correlating the diet with pain. How it correlates diet with pain? By means of the inflammatory substance which is present in the body. Certain food substances are capable of increasing the inflammatory cells in your body. We can understand inflammation happens when there is an injury to the body cells, a biological hazard to our body cells. It may be because of infection or any injury or anything else. Anything can be the reason. The response will be inflammation. The body tries to rectify and repair our own body. When the inflammation happens, it destroys certain cells in the body which is not ideal for the body, and bring about the normal homeostasis. But what happens after the biological problem has gone out? It is actually, there is no more biological problem, but still your body produces this inflammatory cells. This inflammatory cell is going to affect your healthy cells also, and that is going to cause some trigger or release of some painful substances from your body. So this circulating inflammatory substance is a very important source of pain. Patient may come and tell you that suddenly I started getting pain from yesterday. You will be asking a lot of questions, whether you did this work or you had a slip, or did you had a strenuous work, did you sleep well or not. All these questions will be there, but still the problem would be from the food substances. So what to eat to stay away from pain for the patients? The first thing is avoid high glycemic food, whichever releases glucose very instantaneously, which is high in glucose content. So glycemic indexed food should be avoided, first thing. Second thing is to have protein regularly. The protein is a very important ingredient for most of the hormones in your body. And also for a lot of enzymes, protein is essential. So protein is a building block, the one which is useful for building up the muscles. So you have to take protein regularly. Third important thing is try to avoid omega-6 fatty acids. Mind you, I'm not saying about omega-3 fatty acid, which is a very good fatty acid. Omega-6 fatty acids, which is present in most of the oils which are saturated. And it is also present in red meat and other chicken, all these items have omega-6 fatty acids. Try to control that because it has a very good correlation with pain-producing inflammatory substances. Anything, third important thing is anything that is antioxidant, you can definitely have omega-3 fatty acids or antioxidants. Any phytochemical is an antioxidant. And there are studies which states that once the patient gets an acute pain, day 1 and 2 and 3, if the patient stuffs his food predominantly with phytochemicals, he overcomes the pain much better than patient who eat their normal diet. So that's the take-home message. Three important tips for diet. Continue with that and be pain-free. Thank you.